kids, how are you all? So I hope all are keeping well, and we are going to continue with our EVS 2, and that is history, we can say, of Shivaji Maharaj. And we are going to begin with our lesson number 12, the siege of Purandar and the treaty with the Mughal emperor. Okay, so let us see what we have. We are going to look in this lesson. So what is the story further? We are going to look into that. In the last lesson we had seen about Shaista Khan and how he was defeated by Shivaji Maharaj. So this much we have studied. So I hope you have understood. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Okay, so I have provided you the notes also. Now we are going moving forward with our new topic, and that is the siege of Purandar and the treaty with the Mughal emperor. So let us look into the first introduction part and open your textbook page number 45, and you can see the first topic is raid on Surat. After this triumph, Shivaji did not sit idle. Aurangzeb's troops were laying waste the whole of Maharashtra. To bring the emperor to his senses, Shivaji carried out his daring raid on Surat. Surat was so far away from Pune that no one but Shivaji could have thought of this daring raid. Surat was then a great center of trade in the Mughal emperor and a very rich city. Shivaji carried out the raid successfully and brought home a booty worth lakhs of rupees. Shivaji did not forsake ethics in the raid of Surat. He spared the churches and mosques. He did not show disrespect to women. So in the first paragraph, what we have seen is raid on Surat. So who did and raid on Surat, what, how it was done, what and all things happened, we are going to look into that. So after this triumph, Shivaji, like after whole of the thing with Shaista Khan, Shivaji did not sit idle. He did not sit like that only, no, now I have defeated Shaista Khan also, now I will sit idle like that way, not do anything. Idle means what? Sitting, sitting like that only, without doing anything. Okay, so Shivaji did not sit idle. Instead, what happened at that time was Aurangzeb's troops, Aurangzeb's army were laying waste. Laying waste means what? They were destroying whole of the Maharashtra. So his troops, his army was destroying whole of Maharashtra. So to make Aurangzeb understand, his and his army understand about their mistakes, Shivaji Maharaj decided to teach them a lesson. Okay, so what happened? Shivaji Maharaj decided to put a raid on Surat. Now Shivaji Maharaj is in Surat and Shivaji Maharaj is in Pune, and he wanted to raid which place? Surat. So no one would even in dreams think of, because this distance was very far between Pune and Surat, so nobody would even think of attacking with the whole of coming with a such army and attacking a place very far from our place. So that was very difficult, isn't it? So but Shivaji Maharaj had thought about it, and therefore he went for attacking Surat. Now what specialty they told us? Surat was a very good and famous center of trade, and it was a very rich city. It had lot of money, we can say. So it was a very rich city, and that was the center of trade for whose empire? Mughal empire. So Surat is the place, is a center of trade for Mughal empire, and it was therefore a very rich city. Now Shivaji successfully had carried off the raid. He had attacked the place called Surat, and he had brought a lot of money, and he had collected a lot of wealth from Surat. Okay, and he had taken back to which place? To Pune, to his place. Okay, and now Shivaji did not forsake any ethics. It means that Shivaji, whenever the condition of the war may be, he always respected the women. He did not take the war to the churches and mosques. He left that places. Okay, so he did not take his army and he destroyed that churches, temples, mosques. Nothing he did of such sort. He respected women of any category, any religion, whatever it is. So Shivaji always had that ethics in his mind, that discipline, that I will never disrespect women. So that was there in his mind. Okay, further, the raid on Surat drove Aurangzeb into a furious rage. He now decided to put an end to the Maratha kingdom. He ordered his great general Mirza Raje Jai Singh to humble Shivaji. To assist Mirza Raje in the campaign, he sent with him his trusted Sardar Dilair Khan. The two landed in the Deccan with a huge army and an unlimited funds. Swaraj was in real danger. Now in the next paragraph we can see, now when Shivaji Maharaj had attacked Surat, the place under Aurangzeb, which was attacked by Shivaji Maharaj, he got very angry. He became very furious. Furious with rage means very, very angry. He became very angry. Now he had decided, now I will teach this Maratha and this Shivaji Maharaj a lesson. I am going to end them at any cost. Like that way, Aurangzeb started yelling, we can say. Like he became very angry. So what happened? He took an, what we can, decision in his, firm decision in his mind that I will finish this Maratha kingdom only completely, like that way. So he ordered whom? This his great general, and the name of the general was Mirza Rajay Jai Singh, and he told him whom his general, what is his name, Mirza Rajay Jai Singh, okay, to make Shivaji understand, to defeat Shivaji, to show Shivaji that you are not of that kind to rule some kingdom or something like that. So you are below us, you stay like that way. So he wanted to show that you are not to our category. We are kings, we are the supreme powers, you are like our slaves. So that is what basically he wanted to, they all wanted to teach Shivaji Maharaj. Okay, to assist Mirza Rajay, who was there to help Mirza Rajay, who was there, Dilair Khan, he was in Sardar and very good Sardar in the court of Aurangzeb. This two, Dilair Khan and this Mirza Rajay, with a very huge army and a lot of money, they had come and they had started to attack the Maratha kingdom, and this Maratha kingdom was in real danger now. Immediately after, and they had come to the Deccan part. Correct. Our Maratha empire was set in Deccan part also. Correct. So they came to attack over Deccan part. Immediately after his return, now Swaraj was in danger. And further what they're telling, immediately when Shivaji Maharaj had written after the attack in Surat in 1664 AD, which year? 1664 AD, Shivaji Maharaj's dad, Shahaji Rajay, had died due to an accidental death, we can say it was there. It was not like natural death, an accidental death had happened. He went for hunting, and therefore after some accident happened and his Shahaji Rajay had expired, his death had occurred. Now Jizabai and Shivaji Maharaj were completely broken. They were very sad. They were crying, we can say. So Shivaji Maharaj, he holded his mother to the chest like this way, and he started to make her feel like, don't worry mom, we will be fine. So he started to, what we can say, console his mother, okay, to try to make her happy, to make her normal, right? Yeah, so this is what happened, and this is what we have learned in this paragraph, Raid on Surat. So have you understood, kids?